guys, it's Kai here with Kai's Canine Boot Camp. Been off for a while, but I'm back today, and we are going to talk about Rottweilers as service animals. So, I'm going to keep this one more short than I did with the Huskies and not go quite as in-depth, because a lot of this you could research yourself, so if you want to know more about it, you should look into it yourself. You should do that anyways, even with the Husky video, before getting a dog of any specific breed, because if you're not prepared for it, why would you get it? That's kind of just asking for you to unintentionally neglect your dog and their needs. So make sure you are looking more into these breeds yourself as well. But I guess I kind of will go with my own recommendations here. So Rottweilers, what were they originally bred for? Herding and guardian livestock, and livestock guardian. So they were herding the livestock from one place to another and protecting them on the way. That's what they were originally bred for. Since then, they've been in guard work of property. I still have seen very few used for herding, but there's other breeds that are just better for it, so they're not used for it as frequently. I have seen them in service work. I have seen them in protection work, bite work, a lot of different sports. They're a pretty versatile breed. They were also one of the first guide dogs. Take that with a grain of salt though, because they didn't exactly have a standard like we have now for service animals. But they were one of the first guide dogs. So, what are the cons, I guess you could say, to Rottweilers? Well, first off, when you get a backyard bred Rottweiler, which is what you would get if you decide to try to go and get one from the shelter, most of the time if they're being rehomed for a cheap price, that's a backyard bred Rott, and there's usually something very wrong with them. Or if you go to the wrong breeder who doesn't health test their animals and doesn't care about the temperament, they just breed them for the money. Those tend to be some of the worst dogs I've ever worked with. Backyard bred Rottweilers are such genetic messes. They are crazy, crazy, crazy dogs. And they're not the only breed, but backyard bred Rottweilers are a breed, are like a whole nother breed from a well-bred Rottweiler. Like they're so crazy energy, hyperactive. A lot of them have anxiety issues, aggression issues, out the wahoo with humans, other animals, other dogs, and then the amount of health issues you get from backyard bred Rottweilers. So if you're going to go with a Rottweiler for service work, I absolutely would 100% say do not get a backyard bred Rottweiler. If you're gonna go through the shelter, I don't mind that as much, but you still need to be very careful with the dog that you select and make sure you do have it temperament tested. Either you can do it or have a professional do it. But you have to be very careful with the Rottweiler you get from a shelter. So that's really like the biggest thing to worry about. Along with health issues, Rottweilers can get pretty big. As I always say, the bigger the dog, the better they usually are, but also the more health issues you find in them. Rottweilers, they get pretty big. I want to say their average is anywhere from like 90 pounds to 125-130 pounds, somewhere in that range. You're gonna want to look it up to be for sure, but they're pretty big dogs. Obviously females are gonna be smaller, males are gonna be bigger, so it's really depending on what you need. If you want them for mobility work, which they tend to do great at, make sure you're getting a very well-bred male Rottweiler, because they're going to get on that higher end of the scale. I would say generally though, Rottweilers don't have that bad of a temperament when they're well-bred and they were well-socialized and well-trained from the get-go. I'd say a lot of Rottweilers are pretty great dogs. The ones that I have met that had what they needed to be a good dog, they turned out really well. That means they came from stable lines, meaning their parents weren't messed up in the head and they decided to breed them anyways, and they didn't have many health issues in their lines, or they didn't have them at all. So it means a well-bred dog with a stable temperament and proper training and socialization from a young age. The Rottweilers that have had all of that, amazing dogs. I have no issue with them at all. I think they would make great service animals. They're not the one that I would recommend most. Again, for me, I will always recommend a Labrador Retriever over any other breed, because they do have the highest success rate and they're the easiest to work with. They are very good for beginner handlers, very good for even experienced handlers, have a very good chance of not washing out, have a very high success rate. And even then with Labrador Retrievers, again, I'm going to say go with a well-bred because you have even better chances then. But with Rottweilers, if you have a well-bred Rottweiler, you socialize it and train it properly, and you do have experience with dogs, I'd say go for it. If this is something that you want to go for, absolutely. Rottweilers are great dogs when they have a good handler, and a lot of them have been pretty successful in service work. Obviously, they're not even top. So I say go for it if you have experience, especially if you have experience with Rottweilers as pets, or you have experience with similar guardian breeds. You're gonna give them the best chance at succeeding, and I have no issue with that. I have no issue with you working any breed, really. But there's just certain breeds that if you're gonna go for it, you need to expect a wash, pretty much, because you're asking for them to go completely against their breed standard for it to work in service work. However, with Rottweilers, it wouldn't be totally outside of the box for their breed if they succeeded in service work, not even their breed standard. So I don't see why not. Go for it if you'd like. I think they make good service dogs. They're very good for people who need a bigger dog for mobility. They're one of the top ones I would recommend if you need an extra large breed, would be a Rottweiler. But my number one recommendation there is a Newfoundland. Rottweilers do have a lot of health issues, so that's something to look into if you are planning to have them as a pet or as a service animal. They are prone to a lot of health issues. You want to look into that, see if that is something that you would be capable of handling if it arose in the dog. They can be extremely unstable when they aren't provided what they need with socialization, training, and being well bred, which could result in pretty severe aggressions. They can be animal aggressive either way. Some of them that I have met being well-bred, well-socialized, and well-trained, they were pretty rude when playing with other dogs, which is very quickly going to result in a fight. It takes one dog to not tolerate that behavior, and that's going to cause a fight, and you don't want that, but it could happen. I would say most of the Rottweilers I've met have had pretty rude interactions with other dogs. Most of them have like a sit-and-wait type of behavior. If you don't understand what that means, basically they don't go for the other dog straight away, either to play or to attack. They kind of watch the other dog, which could make another dog feel threatened. It's unlikely to, but it's possible, especially if that other dog's a pretty nervy dog, feeling like they're being stalked, because it's basically what the Rottweilers are doing. And then they just kind of pounce on them, and they tend to do it just so husky-like. I've talked about how huskies are rude. Huskies just go straight for it. They're in the other dog's face. They play very rough. That's what causes the attack. With Rottweilers, they sit and wait. Hi, chipmunk. Oh, bye. They sit and wait, and then once they feel like it's time to go and interact, they go for it. So they're stalking the other dog, and then they just bombard them very quickly. So what can happen is another dog is like, okay, this dog isn't gonna play. I'm cool. I'm gonna be calm now, whatever. And then they come and rush them. But that dog is no longer ready to play, could cause a fight, could also cause a fight because a lot of Rottweilers are in the other dog's face. Rottweilers tend to be a very confident dog. I would say I've seen some of them that I feel are too confident, almost cocky. And those dogs often cause fights as well, because they're just rude. They feel like they can do whatever they want, and they can't. Then when another dog corrects them, it starts a giant fight. You know, you do need to monitor their behavior. There are a lot of dogs that can be very rude and pushy, especially when they're young. So you need to make sure that you are stepping in, especially if you're having them interact with dogs that you don't know very well. Don't allow them to do that, because it could cause a serious fight. If you know that other dog well, and you know that they tend to be very tolerant and at most will correct your dog, that's fine. I do allow my dogs to correct each other to get across that they have boundaries and you're not supposed to push those. But it is something you need to monitor from a young age with Rottweilers, making sure they are interacting appropriately, not being too pushy, not being rude and in their face, not coming on too harshly to other dogs. So that's something you need to be aware of, and from a very young age you should have control, or start working for control around other dogs, to where they're not even trying to engage with another dog until you tell them that it's okay to. That's a huge part of socialization. It's not about letting them interact with other dogs or people. It's about being able to ignore those distractions. That's really what socialization is about. Okay, you're not going to react to this. So that's something you want to work on from a young age. I would say some very good things about the Rottweiler: their size, depending on your needs. They have a short coat, so it's very easy to keep up with their grooming. When they are well-tempered, they're very confident dogs. Even the ones that were pretty unstable, lack of confidence was not much of an issue in Rottweilers from what I have seen, and I have worked with a lot of Rottweilers. That's not to say Rottweilers cannot be underconfident, but it's less likely to happen than with some other breeds. So naturally, they tend to be very confident and brave dogs, which is very good for service work. They are pretty smart dogs. Wouldn't call them the most intelligent. I feel like they're pretty goofy, kind of ridiculous sometimes with their behavior, but I wouldn't call them dumb either. They're pretty smart, not too hard to train. They're not like super stubborn or anything. They are decently eager to please with their people. Not quite to the point like a lab, but kind of in that in between. They're moderate to train, and most of the time it's really just about keeping their interest in training. Other than that, I mean, they're decently easy to handle. I would say that you should have a bit of experience with dogs before getting one, but you don't need to be an expert handler before getting a Rottweiler as a pet or a service dog. So yeah, overall, again, like I said, if you feel like getting a Rottweiler, go for it. If you have the experience, if you have the money to pay for a well-bred Rottweiler, and you're willing to put in the time and effort of socializing heavily with that dog and, really keeping up with training on them, I'd say go for it. They're pretty good dogs. I love Rottweilers personally. This is not a breed that I would say I would never own. I would definitely own a Rottweiler at some point in my life if the opportunity came. I have no problems with Rottweilers. Love them. I find them to be quite goofy, quite fun to work with. I find them to be very, very loving with their people. Pretty decently aloof with strangers. Not all of them, but some of them are kind of like, I don't really care that you're here. But they're not necessarily naturally aggressive, I guess you could say. I do love Rottweilers, so I really have no problem with you going for it if that's what you want to do. I don't have any huge negatives here. I would say that you should have some experience in handling dogs before owning a Rottweiler, or as to any extent, and you should be prepared for the possibility of a wash, which you should be prepared for with any dog. I wouldn't say it's as likely for them to wash as a husky, but it's still a decently high probability. So it's still something you need to be a little more prepared for, and really research the breed before getting them, looking into the health issues that they can get, paying attention to signs of that, looking into the heavily researching the breeders that you are thinking about going through, looking into their common behavioral issues and making sure you're taking all the steps necessary, or possible to try to prevent those issues from arising, and just working with your dog from a young age to keep them under control. If you think you can do all those things and you have the capability of doing all those things, go for it. They're great dogs. I absolutely love them. So yeah, that's it. I tried to keep it more short this time, so let me know if you prefer me to do the husky style, where I'm really going in depth about the history, health issues, etc., etc., or if you prefer this style where I'm kind of just giving basics of the breed and giving my recommendation. Anyways, that's everything for this video. If you have any other breeds that you'd like me to go over that weren't mentioned in the previous video, go ahead and leave a comment. Follow us on Instagram at Kylie's Service Canine, or on Facebook at Kylie's Canine Boot Camp. We are on both platforms. So go follow us there. And yeah, any other video suggestions that you have or videos that you would like me to do, I guess, leave them in the comments and I'll get to them eventually. See you guys next time I can do a video. Bye.